Greetings, this is Peter Burns, and I am coming to you from beautiful La Jolla. I'm sitting here at the ocean across from where I live, and I wanted to share with you the story of the biggest deal I've ever done. I've been an entrepreneur since the age of 19 officially, so it's been 42 straight years and 150 startups. And I came to La Jolla about 2 years ago as a result of a business I started with a partner back east. That business that I started had to do with unused time inside multi-million dollar vacation villas. While I was living in Vegas a few years ago, I came up with a concept that took a way to monetize the unused time in multi-million dollar vacation villas to the benefit of the homeowner, as well as to create a financial model. And I tried it out and it worked. And in effect, I figured out a way how to trade luxury goods to the homeowner for a block of vacant time subject to availability. And I traded it dollar for dollar, retail for retail, but I was purchasing it at cost of 20 or 30 cents on the dollar from the luxury goods manufacturers, which allowed me to arbitrage the spread between what I got for the remarketed property and what I paid for it. And where I was able to actually market that successfully to the consumers looking for a deal, I could rent property that was not actually rentable by the owner or the representatives of those vacation villas. And that's because the average utilization is 26% of these beautiful vacation villas around the world. There's usually 5 listings and the owner tries to rent it, et cetera, et cetera. And the result is it's empty almost 3/4 of the time. So because of the ability for me to offer to a closed user group the same property for 40% less than the owner could, I was able to figure out a way to monetize that transaction. And I arbitraged the spread between my cost of the luxury goods that went into acquiring that time and the price that I would get for a closed user group. A closed user group is simply not public information. You have to belong to some sort of firewall that allowed you to have access to the inventory at the lower than market rates. This way you wouldn't cannibalize the actual retail value of that property, getting everybody upset with you, such as the listing agents and the owner of the property. Because once it got out that you could get the same property from me for less, the owner would never get full retail again. Long story short, I put the deal together, hunted down a guy to become my partner that I had learned the luxury business from years ago, who had started the first Destination Club, which I was a member 17, 18 years ago. And I did 60 transactions, 60 different rentals for 60 different properties with 60 different acquisitions of the luxury goods, made $500,000 in gross sales even before I had a website. So I knew I was onto something. Then I was introduced to a gentleman who lives here in La Jolla, who owned the 4th largest airline ticketing company in the world. And he would spend a couple million dollars a month in online advertising and generate about 12,000 phone calls a day to his 1,100 people in various call centers around the world, resulting in about 2,000 airline tickets being sold a day to the tune of about $400 or $500 million. Well, the margins on airline tickets are very bad, very poor, and he was making bupkis considering how much he had to put out in order to generate that business. So when he found out that I was making about 40 cents on the dollar with my new innovation, he invited me to come out, and I did, and I came to La Jolla to meet him to negotiate a deal where he would become a partner of mine, and I fell in love with the place. So I gave up everything back east, and I just stayed. And I buy clothes when I need them, and I was staying at Airbnbs for a long time until I rented a little one bedroom, which is two blocks from the ocean where I am right now, and I never left. It's been 2 years. So, long story short, I put a deal together with this gentleman, and then I had done a blog on LinkedIn, and it got picked up by 320 or 340 media resources, and it was basically called Villas of the New Five-Star Hotel. And I made the case why staying in a private villa, especially through me at 40% off retail, would allow you to have privacy, much more luxury than you would at a five-star hotel, and you wouldn't be sharing any of the amenities with a bunch of other strangers. And that generated a lot of traffic, and it generated a lot of interest to the point where I actually received a phone call from a gentleman who was head of business development for the largest travel aggregator in the world. And that travel aggregator had 1,000 corporate clients representing 130 million vacationers, or I should say travelers, who were all employees of those 1,000 corporations. And their business model was to charge a lot of money for modules, up to $250,000 for 5 modules, such as hotels, which they provided for 30 to 70% off the best internet pricing. Then they also offered flights. They offered everything else. 5 different modules that they offered to their corporate clients so that they could then pass on the savings as an employee benefit to all of their tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of employees. And so they approached me because they saw how I had figured out how to offer these beautiful vacation villas at very, very low rates. And they wanted to know my secret sauce, which I didn't tell them at first, but then they asked me to put my inventory in their inventory. So I went about to create a relationship with this large travel aggregator. That resulted in me knowing the owner of that company well, and I was able to then introduce the airline company that I was at here in La Jolla to the aggregator company, and I got permission from the owner of the aggregator company to hire away his business development officer, and we started our own travel company. I partnered up with the airline company. I used the booking engine from the aggregator and hired away the business development officer, who became the president of the new company, which started last May and was actually cash flowing a month later. We have about 90 different corporate clients generating, I'm going to say, commissions or travel commissions of $120,000, $150,000 a month. And it's been ascending step by step. I don't think it's ever going to be a really, really super profitable business until we hit tens of thousands of different clients. But in the meantime, it created a platform. And that platform was a combination of travel at discounted rates to corporations, which became the way that I just did the largest deal of my life in 42 years. And that happened because I was introduced to a gentleman who was a Vietnamese American. He and his brother were orphaned back at the Tet Offensive in Vietnam. Now, I almost was there because I enlisted in the Army at 17 as an infantry soldier and then was preparing to go over to the East for battle. But thank God I was appointed to West Point, went to their prep school, won a ROTC scholarship to UVA, started my first business as a result of a course I took, only available to fourth-year students, called Entrepreneurship, et cetera, et cetera. The end of my college career, end of my military career, but at the beginning of an entrepreneurship history of 150 different startups over a 42-year span. Long story short, I met this Vietnamese American who had been adopted by an American infantry soldier after his after he was orphaned. He and his brother came here, were raised, and they became superstar tech whizzes, very successful American business people. 23 years ago, the two brothers returned to the unified country of Vietnam, who now enjoyed ally status with America, which is amazing. And they brought the internet with them to the unified Vietnam. And as a result of that, they were able to achieve a 50-year exclusive license to run the internet for the country of Vietnam. And that became a hugely profitable, very large business. In effect, my two Vietnamese-American friends are the equivalent of GoDaddy and Homeland Security for cyber vision, for cyber protection security, for the country of Vietnam. And as a result, all the junior ministers that they dealt with 23 years ago are now the president of the country, deputy prime minister, 7 out of 13 of the ministers, which is equivalent to cabinet positions. So these two fellows are extremely well wired into the country of Vietnam. In effect, as far as I'm concerned, they are the country of Vietnam. So one of the other things that they invented along the way was the way to process visas to Vietnam electronically. Press of a button. 300 databases are accessed and you receive your fully operational visa to the country of Vietnam instantaneously. Now that replaces all the paperwork and the time lag for mailing in your passport and having it laboriously administered by the internal Vietnamese group who then issue your visa and you get it weeks later. So they also negotiated a deal where they have the exclusive rights to issue electronic visas to the country of Vietnam. Now, these fellows have 350,000 URLs, .vn, and one of their companies is travel.vn and hotels.vn. So when they heard from a mutual friend that I had a booking engine with 1 million hotels, all of our villas, all the airlines, they wanted to negotiate a deal to incorporate that booking engine with the travel.vn, et cetera, et cetera. Well, what began on an 8-month negotiation and trials and tribulations of an American doing business with Asians resulted in a contract, which I now have for 10-year duration. And that contract specifically allows me to participate in 15% of all travel originated, all profits originated from this huge deal I put together by acting as the introducing partner to the travel aggregator and the Vietnamese for their own master license, which allows them access to all of the inventory and the booking engine, et cetera, et cetera. They're busy putting up all of their websites. All of their websites featuring all this inventory include the button that issues the online visa. And I'm also entitled to 5% of all visas issued online by my partners to the country of Vietnam. Now, the best part is, in 2019, this license to issue online visas becomes law. And the country of Vietnam will no longer take visas paper-wise. You can't mail in your passport and apply for your visa. You have to go through my partners who issue the online visa. And I got 5 points of every single person going to the country to Vietnam. There were a little under 13 million people last year that went to Vietnam. It is on the ascension. It's the hottest spot in the world. The beaches are the finest in Asia, yada, yada, yada. And it has become a haven for travelers, sophisticated travelers around the world. So it appears that this transaction with the 15 points on all travel profits and 5 points on every visitor to the country of Vietnam will end up earning me tens of millions of dollars every year for the next 10 years that my contract is in effect. And like I said, my contract is with my partners, who in effect are the country of Vietnam. And presupposing that the country of Vietnam continues its ascendancy and all is well in the world, I just did the biggest deal of my life, and this is my story, and I'm sticking to it. Thank you.